Good morning, good morning. I'm just having a quick cup of tea in my Emma Bridgewater I Love Market Gardens mug, and I'm just going to take you on a quick tour of the Tudor Cottage front garden. It's lovely to see the bluebells back. I have to go to the nearby bluebell woods to see if I can find any there. Interesting colour tulip and bluebell combination there. There is like a little willow edging, wicker edging, all the way along here. Lupins are going to be crazy this year. That's their third year. All the aquilegias and the geraniums. All of this we put in, apart from this pittosporum. Isn't it a beauty? I'd love to know which one it is. Yeah, weedy bit, that'll be sorted. This is the bit we took out last year. And you can just see the flower heads coming on the lupin. So there was some pretty dull. I don't know what these are, I've forgotten the name of them. But they were all the way under this window. So this is far prettier. Needs a bit of a weed. Last year's Christmas tree. My pile of bricks. You can tell we're still doing projects, can't you? This has been a joy, this wall and this Victorian planter, but they've gone over now. So I have to think of some plans for there. The biggest change has been the roundabout. I've dug the whole thing out except the Unanimous, which is just incredible. The two trees in the middle and the roses. So there's one, two, three roses there. And everything else I've started adding. And I'm making this a white garden. For we get a great full moon on the front garden. And so I think it, for the quality and the luminescence under the full moon will be brilliant. Having said that, I have got my cornflowers in here. I never follow my own rules. There's some pittosporum. These are silver ladies. Deutzias, I can't remember how, I never can pronounce them. These are some crazy Unanimous trees at the front. And I've turfed this bit so I can lay and look up. I won't step on the turf yet because it's fresh. But look up at the hawthorn. It's just beautiful. And there's a crabapple tree in there as well. I do an about turn. Look at these anemones. Oh, just stunning. The cistus is in flower. I've just taken out a plant from in here that was not looking very well. I don't even remember what it was, to be honest. So it's in a pot and it's got another chance to try and get itself better. The tracea is looking a bit sickly. This has been a really wet area of the garden all winter. The olive tree. We get olives off of this, but they're nothing to write home about. We put reeds in here now because of the amount of water in here. and these grass reeds will hopefully suck up some of that water. And I've raised this bed sufficiently to try and keep the roots out of this heavy water area. And this is basically because, I don't know if you can see, it's dry now. There's a ditch that runs beside us, and that takes all the water off the fields and off the cottage gardens. I've got no one in the shepherd's hut at the moment, so I can have a peep in there. Hedgehog house. Yeah, this needs a good tidy up. There's some great plants in here, you just can't see them at the moment. And then the rhododendron, the towering block of the rhododendron, and this stunning tree, which is going to be in flower any second. You can just see here, and we get tons of pollen. This is not a garden for people with hay fever, because you can imagine, I think I shook it last year and showed people. Hang on, just put my mug down. No, it's not ready yet. Oh yeah, you can just about see the pollen is starting to come out. It's an amazing tree. Right, working part of the front garden. Everyone has an untidy area. Excuse me, bit of a coffee throat. This was here when we arrived, and it was just dumped basically in a corner. So I've just made it for this year's leaf mould. And we've got the four compost bins, which have all been dug out and used, and now are being filled back up again. This is 2022's leaf mould. Do you think they're hungry? Yeah, this is where they were over winter, because they've been in lockdown. And then we built this run because of the constant lockdowns. We've built them a fixed run now. Oh, will they focus? It won't focus. I think they want feeding. Do you want feeding? Do you want feeding? They're laying really well. And then under this tree, where the girlies are, the girls and the boys are, we've got our shady garden with our epimediums. More bluebells, love bluebells, foxgloves. We've got ferns. Oh, sorry, I nearly whacked myself on the head. And then my hammock, which is incredible on a hot sunny day. So this border from the back, this is a new cherry tree, which I showed on my Instagram. Absolutely been beautiful. It's a weeper, and again I'm kind of using it to suck up the excess wet from our winters. This azalea, it will be incredible in probably a week's time. We've got more of the anemones, the alalanchier tree, that's been stunning, multi-stem sedums. I love the sedums. And through here, we have lots of herbaceous perennials, including the forget-me-nots, daisies, we've got the lupins, bleeding hearts, we've got delphiniums, poppies, we've got geraniums, roses, cornices. There's a couple of magnolia trees. This is all borders that we put in, leading up to the cherry trees. We desperately need to do a dump run. Ugh. Lots and lots of waste found.